I have someone I have a lot of respect for that I actually want to introduce to all of you. This person I actually met on social media. And, you know, she's been following me through social media and she's been watching my journey. And she was like, man, I just love what you're doing. You know, you're young, you're ambitious, you're going places. And I want to feature you on, you know, one of my podcasts, because what it is that I do is I help entrepreneurs attack their mindsets, identify their brands, identify who they are and why they're doing what they're doing, to overcome anything that holds them back from getting ahead in life. And I was like, wow. I was like, you never know who's watching you, you know? So we did a podcast together. Her name is Dr. Toni Hatton. She is what you call the attractive thinker. She has a movement going on, helping millennials, helping entrepreneurs break through any mental barriers they have that can actually stop them from getting to the levels of success that they deserve to have. I mean, she's an industry specialist in this area. She's a seasoned MLM professional. She's been in a lot of different MLM companies. You know, she's been in MLM business from 2007 all the way through to 2018. I mean, she's an author. You know, she has a huge platform on social media. She's just been able to do some phenomenal things, and her work has even helped people from committing suicide. Sometimes we get so stressed out in business that it gets that bad that some people want to take their own lives. They give up, or marriages fall apart, or relationships are failed, all because in the mind they don't have it together, because they see where they want to go, but they get discouraged very easily, or they have these roadblocks that they mentally can't overcome. And I said, man, after our podcast, I was so excited to say, listen, I want you to talk to the team. You know, given the fact that you've had almost 10 years of experience in building something like this, like, how often do we come across people and we're trying to share with them that we're building this business and we get pushback, or we get naysayers, or we get negative feedback from our friends and family? Like, how often has it happened to you? Drop a one in chat, right? How often does it happen to you in your business that you feel like this isn't working, so let me just go back to the job that made me unhappy? Drop a one in chat. How many of you have ever felt like giving up? Sometimes you just mentally check out and you say you can't do it, because you thought that coming into this business, you were going to have the success like, you know, the Curlins Cassius, the Alfred Nixons, the Mike Burgos, the Lakeishmers. Like, you just came in and figured, like, if I just work this like 2-3 months, boom, I'm going to be a millionaire, right? And then you realize it don't go that way. You realize you're going to get test after test after test after test before you have your breakthrough. And too oftentimes people check out before the breakthrough. And so I was like, man, what a powerful marriage or connection to be able to connect with Dr. Toni Hatton, as I myself am going through the ups and downs of the business, as I myself am fighting through adversities and challenges, as I myself am looking to figure out, okay, how can I mentally overcome what is the transitions that my life has been going through so that I can get to the next level? And I know that I'm not alone in this. And so I wanted to share her with all of you, because I think that her message can really help shape you guys, you know, to move forward. And definitely hearing from someone that's not just in the business. Like, sometimes we talk to the leadership and, you know, sometimes you feel like it's biased, because you're like, yeah, you guys are drinking the Kool-Aid, you guys are all in, but listen, it's not working out for me. I'm bringing in someone from the outside that has experience within this industry, that has experience with entrepreneurship, that has been able to guide people through their breakthroughs. And so she's just going to take a few moments this morning to help you guys through your breakthrough. And so it's with my great pleasure, let me just give you the host. It's with my great pleasure to bring to the front of the room a young lady I have a lot of respect for. She goes by the name of Dr. Toni Hatton, Miss the Attractive Thinker. I want to say welcome. Good morning.
Can you hear me?
I can awesome. Hear you.
Great day to you, Tiffany, Renee, and the Mogul Nation. You know, I always say that it is not another day. It is a new day. And Tiffany, I just want to thank you so much for inviting me to this wonderful platform of leaders in your company. Because like you said, I found you on social media and immediately you stood out to me because of the leader that you are. Discipline stands out. commitment stands out. It has a look, and you can see it on people. And that's what I spotted on you at such a young age. And I was like, this lady is on the move and she is going somewhere. And I just wanted to share your story with the Attractive Thinker generation. And thank you so much for inviting me to your platform as well. You know, Tiffany, Renee, today I want to talk about the spirit of the leader, because a lot of times, like you said, we take on the entrepreneurship journey and we take on these businesses that we deem to make our lives better. We want to use them like in the video they were talking about. This is not about you. This is about your family, or this is about your mom or your dad. You know, when we take on the entrepreneurial journey, it is the spirit of the leader that we're also taking on, because that you automatically set yourself apart. You're different. You're now in a leadership position, and in a leadership position, you automatically have followers. Now, you have to understand that you are now a light. People are looking to you. You know, when I first came onto this platform and the music was playing and I saw different videos popping up, different cameras coming onto the scene, there was a young lady in a car. And the music was playing, and she had on like this striped shirt, and I recognized her. She stood out to me, and she was just driving down the road. I don't know where she was going, but wherever she was going to light the atmosphere because of the energy that she was in. And that's what we do as leaders. There's an energy that comes with the leader, but what we first need to understand, because I'm a mindset expert, what we first need to understand, we have to get that into our mindset. First, we have to get that into our consciousness. We have to understand we didn't just join a business. We stepped into leadership. When you step into something, you're also stepping out of something else. And we stepped out of a comfort zone, a routine. Number one, in order for us to leave from where we were, it had to no longer serve us. There had to be something about what we just left that wasn't advancing us forward, wasn't helping us to grow. It wasn't bringing out the best in us. So when you step into entrepreneurship, you have to understand you just stepped out of something, and you don't want to bring that something with you. And when you recognize it, see, as a leader, you know, I understand, Tiffany, Renee, why you have the Mogul Nation, why you have this call, this team call every single day, because we live in darkness. We are lights that shine in darkness, and it takes energy and it takes effort to do anything that we do in our lives, to get up out of the bed. You know, it's not easy, because the normal routine thing to do would be to just lay there for a few more minutes, you know, to go to the gym. It takes effort. And sometimes as a leader, you know, when you embark upon entrepreneurship, you're wondering like, why is everything so hard? You know, they told me to do step A and step B and step C, and I can do that, but it seems like it's so hard. Again, it's because you're coming up against these systems, and we have to understand, have you ever heard somebody say, you know, it doesn't take all of that. Oh, they're working out, like another a camera that popped up. It looked like someone was walking while they were joining Mogul Nation's call this morning. You know, they're getting it in, doing it all at once. And, you know, somebody might say, well, it doesn't take all of that. Or I call it, you know, as attractive thinkers, we call it having our mental breakfast. This right here, this team call would be something that we would include in our mental breakfast. Just like you eat a physical breakfast, you need a mental breakfast with your affirmations, affirming yourself. Sometimes we're looking for these affirmations outside. Well, why are they not saying anything about what I'm doing? Or why isn't this one supporting me? We have to affirm ourselves, because we're the leader. When we step into leadership, we're responsible for the outcome now. We're responsible for making sure we're on fire. We're responsible for making sure our mind is right. We're responsible for making sure we're not distracted and everybody else's drama is not our drama, because as a leader, people are depending on you. Now, leaders carve new generational paths. So a lot of times, Tiffany, Renee, attractive thinkers come into my sessions and they want to know, well, Dr. Tony, what is it that keeps your fire lit? What makes you get out of bed every single day happy and excited about life and about what you're doing with your life? It's a fortified why. You have to have that why tight. You have to have that why ever before you. Why are you doing this? And it has to be more than just about money. Because money without meaning is misery. You can have all the money in the world, but if you don't have your inner game tight, you're just not happy. And that's the goal. That's the ultimate goal. Are you happy? Do you have peace? Are you growing? Is the environment conducive for you to grow? And this is what leaders consider. And that's why we step into disciplines. That's why we do things differently from the masses. That's why when we sit down and we pull a plate up to our table to eat, our plate looks different than everybody else's plate, because we eat to live instead of living to eat. You know, being a leader, it calls for being different. We have to be different. So I'm here to inspire the spirit of the leader in you and give you an explanation as to why you have to do things differently, why you have to come on this call every single morning, why you have to hear this music, because you have to step into the energy of a leader. Success is an energy. Success is a mindset, and you have to step into that energy. Have you noticed, like, sometimes you wake up in the morning, you just don't feel like getting up, but as soon as you do, that energy shifts and changes, and you feel like, oh yes, I forgot, I got this to do, and I can do that, and I got this call to make, and I have this client to follow up with. But that energy, if you're still laying in the bed, that's a whole different kind of energy. Laying in the bed, the energy of laying in the bed means comfy, cozy, you know, warm, pull the covers up over my head, get a few more hours of sleep, or whatever. That's not the energy of a leader making phone calls, making things happen, making follow-up calls, transacting revenue, you know, growing and expanding and serving your solutions to people that have problems. So everything is really energy. And in order for us to be successful as leaders and step into the spirit of a leader, every single morning you have to step into the spirit of a leader? Because when you go to sleep, it's almost like going back to ground zero. And you wake up, you got to shut the negativity down, your negative self-talk. You have to remember who you are. You have to remember your goals and your why, and remember what your company told you to do, the incentives that are coming forth that you need to share with your client base, and the bonuses that are available. And you have to, you know, have your mind right. In the midst of all of this, Tiffany Renee, you still have life that's happening. You still have family that you're responsible for. You still have yourself that you're responsible for. In the midst of serving everyone else, you have to take care of yourself. The spirit of a leader is an opportunity also for you to recognize. You have to put this on, just like you put on clothes in the morning. You have to put on the spirit of the leader and remember that you're carving a new generational path. Somebody is watching you. And I always say, if you don't do it, then who will? Who cares enough to break out of a system? Who cares enough to carve a new generational path? Who cares enough to make a mark in the earth? You know, Tiffany Renee, when I go to funerals, I see them differently. People ask me, you know, Dr. Tony, what is your why? One of my big whys is I don't want to leave here and be known for making the best sweet potato pie. You know, I've been to so many funerals, and I've heard people stand over top of the person who was deceased, and they say some really interesting things, should I say. I don't want to be known for, oh, you know, Dr. Tony was so funny. That's it. After all I've been through in my life, after all the years that God has given me, the best that people got from me was that I was funny. Now, unless I'm a comedian, that's my profession, I don't want to be known for just being funny, or I can make the best macaroni and cheese, or her house was always so clean. No. What difference did I make? What impact did I make in the earth? And this is the thing that we as leaders need to be mindful of. Time has a way of lulling us back to mediocrity and lulling us back to sleep, so to speak. And have you ever heard the phrase that there are 1%, the 1%ers in the world own all the money, or regulate all the money, or are successful? What does that mean? That means that 99% of the population, 99% of the people that you see are comfortable, are okay with the mediocrity and the routine and the mundane, or they are stuck in trying to happen and not really crossing over, stuck in the pursuit and never acquiring, always pursuing and never acquiring. When we think about the 1% and the 99%, as a leader, you're the 1%, and you have to own that. as a leader, when you step into entrepreneurship, you don't waffle back and forth like, well, maybe I'm not good enough. Maybe I shouldn't have did this. Or maybe I just got caught up in all the hype. And no. The thing that led you to the event, the thing that led you to step into entrepreneurship and to sign up and say that this is what I want to do with my life and I want to do something different, that's the spirit of the leader. You already have it. You already have it. Now, you might say, well, Dr. Tony, if I already have the spirit of the leader, why am I struggling mentally with my mindset? Why am I feeling like this is not what I should be doing? Or I don't get the support that I'm supposed to have. It's because the mind has to be renewed to the action and the decision that you just made with your life. That's why the Attractive Thinker movement is so important. That's why mental health is so important. That's why mindset renewal is so important. The mind has to be renewed to the action that you take. We have to remember we're multidimensional beings. We're not just one being. As soon as you make a decision to do something, don't expect your mind to support you with that. The mind has to be programmed. How is the mind programmed? Through repetition. All you have to do is, like Tiffany Renee, take consistent action every single day. Tell your mind to hold on for a minute until your mind catches up to the new action that you're taking. And over time, you will have rewritten your old mindset. And now you have a new program installed and it runs on automation. All you're doing is creating a whole new program. You left the old program. And I know it took a lot of effort and guts for you to leave where you are and say that I'm a leader. I'm an entrepreneur. I have solutions that solve problems. And I want to step out of my comfort zone and into the forefront of my life. I'm no longer in the back seat being driven. I want to be in the driver's seat because I know where I want my life to go. I know where I'm driving my life to. And the question to you this morning, Mogul Nation, is if you don't do this, look around. Who will? Who's on your right and who's on your left running with you? Who's going to change the course of your bloodline? Will the financial state of your generation change if you don't change it? Who's going to change it? I used to tell attractive thinkers, I said, nobody's going to knock on your door and hand you a life. Nobody's going to do that. And because you're here on this call and you show up every single morning as a team leader, that means that it's you. You're the one. You're the one. So, after you hear this message today, let it be saturated in your spirit that you are the one and that there is no other. And if you don't do it, your generation is going to have to wait at least another 40 years for somebody to be born with the spirit of the leader and carve a new path for your bloodline. So that you all can have time and money freedom, so that you can enjoy the abundance of the earth that you're walking and breathing in. I want you to think about the spirit of the leader and own it. I always share with attractive thinkers, when I begin to speak, I'm dropping gems. So you want to capture these in your attractive thinker notebook, capture these gems, I have taken on the spirit of the leader. And when you say that to yourself, see, you don't have to worry about, well, I got issues over here and I got to figure this out and I got to work. No. When you begin to say, I have taken on the spirit of the leader, do you know as a leader, some issues just fall away? They aren't even of a concern. Some things just take care of themselves because you're a leader. Now, if you're thinking like a follower, you have a follower's mindset, that comes with a whole nother set of issues and circumstances and situations. But as a leader, think about the leaders that you admire. Now see yourself as that. You are that. You might say, but Dr. Tony, I don't feel like that. Let your feelings catch up to the decision that you made for your life. Your feelings don't get to dictate what's going on here. You made a decision. You made a conscious decision. Nobody forced you. It was a willing decision. Now tell your mind to follow. Tell your feelings to catch up with it because you're going. And I used to say to people, listen, you're either going to go with me or you're going to be dragged. Because this train is moving. We're not staying. We're not going to stay comfortable because there's a fire inside of you. Tiffany Renee keeps saying, can y'all drop some of them fire emojis? There's a fire inside of a leader. And that's what keeps driving us forward. So I want to encourage you to keep waking up every single day like that lady in the car. Keep waking up every single day. As soon as your eyes open and you realize you're awake, get excited about that. You get to step into a new day, not another day. This is not another day. You're stepping into a new day that you've never even seen before. And there's something exciting, not waiting for you, but that you're going to activate. There's something, we're out of the mentality that we're waiting on something to happen. No, we make things happen because of who we are. We make things happen because of what the power of the words that we're saying out of our mouths. We make things happen because of the light that we have on the inside. And we've decided to shine brighter. So don't second guess yourself. Don't be wondering, well, this is, you know, why is it so hard? Or why do I have to do all of this? And this is take a lot of distance because you're a leader. And I want to share something so special about leaders. There are people watching you that won't move in their lives until they see you move. They will not write their books until they see you write yours. They will not start their businesses until they see you start yours. They will not even reach revenue levels in their lives until they see you do it first. There's a bigger reason why you have to stay this course and you have to nurture yourself, nurture the leader in you, own the leader in you, honor and respect and love the leader in you, because you're necessary and you're causing a ripple effect all throughout your bloodline, all throughout your circle, all throughout your neighborhood, all throughout your community, wherever you go, even in the market, you're causing a ripple effect because people can not just see the light on you, they can sense it. The spirit of it. Can't you feel people's spirits? Well, they can feel yours. And that's why you have to stay happy. That's why you have to stay excited and on fire. Your fire encourages someone else. Your fire gives other people hope. People are hopeless. And when you enter into the scene, you bring hope as a leader of the Mogul Nation. Back to you, Tiffany Renee.
Drop some fires in the chat for Dr. Tony for bringing in the energy, y'all. Drop some fires in the chat. I mean, wow, that was just a powerful message, the spirit of a leader. Like, you guys don't even realize that you've stepped up to be the leader. You guys have the spirit that's going to change the trajectory of your futures. It's all come down to you because you made a decision. Now you have to stick to that decision. I just want to say thank you so much, Dr. Tony, for that powerful message. I know the team is feeling it. I know some of them got goosebumps. Some of them have chills. Some of them are like, man, I did decide to be that leader. I need to operate in that spirit. I need to keep pressing forward. I didn't realize people were looking up to me. I didn't realize that, you know, I am the one that's going to change the trajectory of my future, of my community. And it's just so confirming to hear it from someone on the outside, right? Drop some fires in the chat if y'all with me. Kiki Joseph said, yes, Miss Kiki Joseph, she went from a low credit score to an excellent credit score. And guess what? She's building her house from the ground up. And she's not even native to this country, but she's living out the American dream. And guess what? Her children are now experiencing what it is like to break generational curses, to set opportunities, and to be that leader in the family. So listen, I just want to say thank you for that. I'm fired up for that. Tammy said, I needed this. Miss Tammy Randall, she's a powerhouse in our company. She's in her 60s and she decided to step out on faith and become an entrepreneur. She did not decide to retire on life. She didn't decide to retire where she was at. She decided to break generational poverty over her family, and she is actively doing it, being a vessel in the community in her 60s. So give it up to Miss Tammy Randall. I know Miss Kay is like, I definitely needed this. Chris Garcia said, let's go. Listen, I'm just super excited for all of us here. We have something special here. And I'm just so thankful, Dr. Tony, that you were able to experience this. It's the second time you came onto our platform. And just always keep us in mind, you know, as you're growing your journey, and come on back to share more messages, because I know the team has well received you. Absolutely. So listen, y'all, we got some things to do, okay? Let's continue to press forward. Let's continue to, you know, break through those barriers. Let's continue to lead from the front, not from the back. Let's continue to step up for not just ourselves, but for those that have a voice that haven't been heard yet, because they're waiting on you to be that person that is involved in their breakthrough. So I just want to say,
share something.
Yes, ma'am. Go ahead.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but I thought about something while you're talking. I know that the Mogul Nation could really benefit from this. You know, while you're talking, I'm thinking about the things that we have to press through. I'm thinking about the mark that we're leaving and the people that are watching us that we don't know about. Because I became an author, there are now three other authors in my family that I was able to help them self-publish their books. See, when you become something new that the family has never experienced before, you give other people permission to do the same thing. And, you know, when I think about the Mogul Nation and, you know, people ask me about my why and, you know, what's the motivation, a defining moment can really shift your life. And I'm gonna take 30 seconds and share this. My firstborn son, he was diagnosed with cancer of the retina in both of his eyes. And I'm sharing this because life is not going to stop happening because you decided to get a life. It's not gonna stop happening. And you cannot say, well, I'm going through this, so I gotta put my business on the side. No, you and your business are one. If the business is not doing well, if you're not doing well in life, your business is not doing well. So I wanna share something with you that will help you keep forging through in the midst of life happening. My firstborn son was 10 months old, diagnosed with cancer of the retina, had to have his eyes removed in order to save his life. He is 36 years old right now, leads a full life because of the faith and belief. And it did not stop me. And this is how the attractive thinker movement began. As a result of showing him how to see without eyes, it enabled me to show people with eyes how to see in life. We have no excuse. We have no excuse. We can hear all kinds of stories of people overcoming and triumphing. We have no excuse. We just got to set our mind, get that mind right, and keep going in that direction no matter what. Back to you, Tiffany Renee.
Wow, that was powerful. That was powerful. To see without eyes, that was powerful. So if her son could see without eyes and we have the eyes to see our visions, what excuses do we have, right? I just want to say thank you for sharing that intimate, you know, testimonial with us. I just know God's got a lot in store for you and all the lives that you're going to change through your impact as the attractive thinker guru. And I just want to say, listen, y'all, don't take this message lightly. Let's go out there today. Let's go out there and really shift lives for people that need us, that need to hear from us. Again, I just want to say thank you, Dr. Tony, for coming on and blessing our platform this morning. The team thanks you so much. Guys, that's why you never want to miss a morning call, because the blessings are pouring through right now. So thank you so much. Listen, guys, you already know what it is. It's Mogul Nation. Drop it in the chat for life. Let's go out there and be great, y'all. See you guys on the next morning call.
The highway. She's living in a world and it's on fire. Filled with catastrophe. But she knows she can fly away.